At Armada Technologies, we get a lot of questions on what is inductive or broadcast mode. What is it? How does it work? What's it good for? Well, what inductive mode is a high-frequency transmission out of this transmitter that radiates out, and any metallic object or conductor in the area that it's radiating will pick up that signal, put that signal on that conductor, and allow you to track it. So in the Pro 800D, this is our Pro 800D, our standard wire and valve locator for irrigation. In this area here, there's a copper coil, and that's the inductive transmitting coil to put that signal on a cable. So to use that function in this locator, I'm going to turn on the locator, I'm going to put it in the broadcast mode here, and I'm going to use my wand to track the signal. Now, with a broadcast antenna, you could consider this a little bit like a shotgun. It's not connecting to just one cable, it's connecting to all cables. I've set it up here against the cable TV line that runs into this home, and right now that antenna is putting a signal on that cable TV cable without me having to get into this box, without me having to unhook anything, so Grandma can keep on the internet while we're doing this. It doesn't affect her. That's the beauty of inductive locating, is you don't have to take things apart, you don't have to use alligator clips. You notice we don't have alligator clips plugged in here like we would if we were connecting to a cable. This is totally inductive, it's totally wireless. So right now I'm sending a signal on there. One of the downsides though is because it's a shotgun approach and it is hitting everything, all the wires in this area that have grounding are going to pick up this signal. Number two, when you're within roughly 15 feet of this box, it doesn't matter what cables you have in the ground, everything is going to light up because you're getting the box itself, not the cables. So if you need to track this section of the cable, this near end, you're going to have to take the box somewhere else, probably the other side of the cable where it terminates, to track this part, because right now the box itself, the signal is going to overload the receiver. So let's make sure I've got a signal. I put the receiver has to be in the broadcast mode. They both have to be in the same mode. But obviously I'm getting a signal, so let's go track a wire. Okay, so we're out here in the yard. I'm transmitting a signal that's being induced onto the cable. And so when I turn my wand up, I have it in the null mode, so I'm looking for a null. Okay, there's my null. I can track it either towards the house, or I can track it back towards the cable box. Pretty standard located. But when I get close to this box, you watch, I'm going to lose the null. Okay, I've lost the null. The reason, if you look there, I'm about 15 feet away from the box. Okay, turn that off, a little noisy. When you get about 15 feet away from the box, I'm actually picking up the box instead of the transmission on the cable. If I want to follow it in this direction, you can see I'm basically taking it right up to the house, right up to the cable box. So that's inductive locating, that's broadcasting. It's very helpful if you want to avoid cutting Grandma's cable line. We could do the electrical line, we could do the phone lines, we could do the dog fence, it doesn't make a difference. Inductive broadcast mode, that's how it works. Now let's show it on an irrigation system. This application, or this portion of it, talks about irrigation systems. Irrigation systems, unlike the cable TV or electrical lines, phone lines, is a little bit different, because you have a solenoid on the system. The solenoid, at a frequency that this uses for induction, which is 175 kilohertz, acts like a big resistor, and as a resistor it knocks signal down. So this mode doesn't work as well as it does on cable TV or electrical, but it is still useful in irrigation. I know this system at this home. There's a valve box underneath my case here. And what I want to do is I want to know where this line goes into this home without having to use my alligator clip. So again, I'm going to use broadcast mode. So I've turned the power on, I put it in broadcast mode, I'm going to set the receiver on broadcast mode because it has to match. Okay. And again, I'm standing right next to the box, so I'm getting signal off the box. I know the cable goes in this direction, I have some experience here. So as I'm close to the box, I don't really get any signal that I can track because I'm getting signal from the box. But as I go down here, it's a weaker signal because of that solenoid, but eventually, right here, I'm getting the null. And that's where my cable line is for my irrigation line. Now think about this for a second. I'm not disconnecting anything on the system. I'm not disconnecting the clock. I'm just taking that broadcast mode, putting it right on top of the valve box, and I'm getting a signal that I can track. So let's see. Make sure it's in broadcast mode. So now I'm tracking the irrigation line going back to the home. And away you go. It becomes a normal track at that point. You're going to get less distance because you're not direct connected to the cable. So that's one thing to remember. Number two, always remember that solenoid is going to give you a dampened response, so you're not going to get as good a signal as you are off other cables or a direct connection mode. But if you're in a hurry, you just want to map out an area, you don't have access to a garage because it's closed, it's going to give you a quick, easy way to track and map out an irrigation wire system, or like we did before, electrical or cable. So for my cat Mittens over there who got in the shot, if you have any questions, give us a call at Armada, and we thank you for watching the video.